Hello everybody, Jose Rodriguez here. I just received, very graciously I might add, because this was not a cheap mailing cost for this person. He is known as the Art of Women Photography in Australia. He owns a Pro 1000 from Canon. And I think he also owns a Pro 1, but I'm not quite sure. Anyway, he's been gracious enough to send me some empties so that we can continue to develop a refilling process for these cartridges. Now, one unusual thing about these carts is that they do not have an ink bag like these do, the PGI 29s. It's just a bare compartment. I took the valve off of this. And by the way, it is a two-way valve, which will allow you to inkjet ink directly into the reservoir. Really strange that they would not even care about making it a single or one-way valve like the Epson carts for the PA-100, for instance, and the earlier 3880s, 3800s, and other larger size cartridges. Yes, they have one-way valves, but there's a way to defeat that. Well, anyway, that's not necessary with this particular type of cartridge. You just have to have the proper tip. And again, we are still trying to figure out how these cartridges vent. In other words, as ink is allowed to emerge into the printer, how does air enter the compartment to basically take up the space that's devoid now by the lack of ink? In other words, as you start drawing ink out, you have to replace it with air. Otherwise, you would have a situation where you would have a vacuum being created inside here. Now, another interesting thing about these is that they have a floating chip holder. Listen, I'll shake it here next to my mic. As you can see, the little black chip holder basically just floats, and I have the parts up here. I showed you that in an earlier video. But refilling these is a relatively simple process, and I will go ahead and show you that. To remove the little alignment cap that has two alignment pins here, or holes for two pins that are located in the ink compartment for each cart, and then a nozzle or stem that connects to the internal portion of the cart to be able to retract ink out of the cartridge. And I think maybe it is a vacuum type system. I don't see any pressurization port anywhere in this cartridge, even after I took that one apart. No hint about a pressurization port, so I'm still kind of scratching my head as to how this works. But the cap is identical to those used by Epson. So this must be a readily available factory part for these carts. They're being used by Epson carts for the PA-100, as well as for these newer IPF 1000 or Pro 1000 cartridges. So first thing we have to do is we would have to remove the cap, which is basically by unsnapping two little catches that are located here. I would use a flat bladed screwdriver, carefully pry them apart and remove this. At that point, that little chip holder will fall out, so you better be able to catch it before it falls out of the cap. Remember, it's floating, because you have to remember what the orientation of it is. And then the chip basically sits, and I'll try to show you this, right there. I don't know if you'll be able to see the chip. The chip is held down via a couple of little welded spots, just like the ones for these and most other Canon cartridges. So you will have to break that and remove that old chip, and just basically with a little blue tack, attach the new chip, which basically sits right on top of those little posts. I don't believe we will have to perform any kind of modification to the chip holder. The back of the chip has a little bubble of resin as well, so we may or may not have to do that. But that's coming as soon as Precision Colors lets me know. They received a set of chips, and again, His price is $15, so, you know, if you were to buy them, he would have to make a profit, so, you know, figure that out. And then the cost of inks. Remember, these go for 55 plus or minus dollars a cartridge. So a 110 ml bottle of ink costs about $15. So you do the math. You should be able to refill one of these for about $12 worth of ink and about maybe, say, $20 per chip. And that puts you in the realm of about $32 per cartridge, which is about just a little over half of what the original would cost you. All right, so once you have this popped, you would remove the chip holder, attach the new chip, and reassemble everything and snap this back on. And so in order to refill, because this is a blind process, we have to know what a empty cart weighs. And if I use my much more accurate microscale, it says that it weighs 33 point something. We'll go ahead and relocate the camera so you can see all of these operations. All right, back in a minute. All right, so let's go ahead and power up the micro scale, and I will put an empty. It says 32.11, and they basically fluctuate a few hundredths of a gram. Problem with this is it only goes to 100 grams, so I cannot use this. I will have to use my less accurate mailing type scale. It does have the capability to display grams, but as you will see, it is off by almost 2 grams. So let's use this as a standard. Let's just say that the empty does weigh 34. So if you add 80 ml or 80 grams of ink, we would say that 34 plus 80 comes up to 114. So we want to achieve 114. And here I have one that I already refilled with water. And it takes, as you saw, it takes a few seconds for it to stabilize 114. Now, let's go ahead and do one. We'll close this, move it out of the way. Okay, folks, so here we go. I have the empty. If you recall, the weight was 32-ish. So here we are. We are starting at an empty weight of 32. What I suggest you do, and this is through my experimentation so far, has been to load 2 syringes, 60 ml, with 40 ml of ink each. You're going to need a special tip that has been notched right here to allow ink to escape laterally, because otherwise it would seal against the poppet valve and you would have a problem. Now what you need to do, this is going to be a much different process than you normally are used to doing, and I'm going to move the camera back so you get a full view of what I will be doing. Basically, you're just going to inject ink, and then that's going to create positive pressure inside this container, which you will then have to release by allowing the plunger to go back. And that is the reason that I have started with only 30. You might want to also start with, say, 30 ml instead, and do it in 30, 30, and then 20. So let's go ahead and begin. Okay, let's go ahead and begin. I have tinted my water with a little bit of black so that you can see the actual solution. So with the special tip installed on the syringe, you're going to press down. Make sure you don't do it over a slippery area like I'm doing here, but you know what I mean. And proceed to inject and allow the cart to vent. Inject, vent. Remember, you are creating a positive condition. And you could also pull back, create a vacuum, and allow the cart to absorb the ink. And that is it. Now you take your next load and you proceed to do the same thing. So now we have 72 grams, 74, we have to reach 114. So you would load another load or have, say, 3 syringes preloaded, ready to go. One with 30, another one with 30, and then the last one with 20, and that would load 80 ml of ink into the cart. At that point, what you could do is press down and let it by itself reach equilibrium. Notice if I pull back and create a vacuum, it's going to suck the plunger back down. If I press, it's going to push the plunger back up. So you want to create a point where the pressure, internal pressure, is equal to the outside. And at that point, you are ready to go. It's a little bit of a tricky method, but one that works perfectly. And so far, like you saw me show earlier, this one is loaded, ready to go. And all you have to do is replace that little chip and insert it back into your printer. It's not going to be such an easy process, but one that once you learn how to do it, it'll come quite easy. In fact, if you want to do this, take your empty and create a vacuum. Basically, insert the syringe, empty syringe, create a vacuum, and pop it out. When you then load the syringe full of ink, it will just suck it right in. Until it reaches equilibrium, it will stop at that point. And then you just keep loading ink by creating a vacuum and allowing the ink to enter. That's another way you can do that. So you can do a vacuum fill or you can do a positive pressure fill. Either way will work, and you just pick the one that is the least messy, I guess. You will make a slight mess, I guarantee it. But that's the price that we pay, and actually it's a badge of honor to get ink on your hands. That says you are a true refiller. And besides, you are helping the environment by not ending up filling, you know, landfills with these cartridges that are being just tossed. This is just the beginning. We are working on an alternative method. It's a little bit revolutionary, but it should work. But we are trying this one first because this is the probably the best way to go. Single-use chips that actually report ink in filling your cartridges via either vacuum or the pressure fill, like I just demonstrated. All right, thank you once again. I want to appreciate everyone who has signed up for Patreon. As a patron, I really, really appreciate it from the bottom of my heart. Thank you for supporting the channel. And so, as always, don't forget to subscribe, share, and like. And until the next time, happy printing, everybody. Bye-bye.